My steps went to town. My steps went really down today. But we were walking along the road where it took us into the future of our mind. Yesterday I was in activity. Oh, sorry for that. The whole day. Until I ended up at a place where I have bought jewelry. A lot of jewelry. At a certain jewelers that have designed his own jewelry. And yesterday I wanted to talk about the lady at the bus stop that had ancestors for 5 generations in Israel, in Jerusalem. And I was born in Jerusalem. On my question, where are you born? I'm born in Jerusalem. Here, straight over here, at Charles Sedek Hospital. I think that was the place, Charles Sedek. The Danish lady I know here, she also have worked on this Charles Sedek. It's a well-known hospital. And good. And she told me that her father died, was shot under the liberation fight here in 1948. I met a guy today, just entering outside, going outside. While I was walking, I saw a guy on his phone walking, and it seems to be easy to go guy, and I said shalom and hey, nice day, and he agreed, and we talked a little bit about the situation. He, after me introducing myself, coming from Norway, I asked him, have you been to Norway? Yes, I have been to Norway, and was there for 3 months in 1985 or something, I think. And this guy, he said, we Israel have to do what we need to do in order to cover ourselves. Have you ever heard about a Jewish terrorist shooting around in Oslo? No, you will never hear about that. But what is common is an Islamic terrorist, yet they are blaming the Jews always. So that was this man, and I went to the groceries in order to buy myself tomatoes, and I met a guy that was having his grocery shop closed down. He sold it to another guy, and I was just passing by, because I want always to pass by this guy. He seems to be a very nice guy. And he recognized me, was happy to see me, and asked whether this Bet Norvegia, this House of Norway, was closed. Yes, but it should be open, as should be the house in Ashdod. Yes, he totally agreed, and we need to think in an Israeli way in order to open up. We need, if we want to be blessed, we need to open up for those that are in need. But we are good, he said, we are good. And later on I wanted to take a picture of this this place, Islamic Art Gallery. because as a Jewish archaeologue told me many, many years ago here in Israel, maybe it was in 2011, 10 or 12, I don't remember exactly, but she told us while sitting at the cafe, she was a student, archaeological student, and she said that the Arabic themselves, the Arab themselves, they have no interest in their own findings, the archaeology of their own history. They are not interested. Even here, we find a lot of Arabic culture and Arabic art. You see, the Arabic culture and art and history have impacted the whole world, like mathematics, like whatever art history or mathematical or scientific exploration they have been doing. They have impacted the whole world, but they don't care about that anymore. Islam is their own foundation, and it's all about rejecting what is kind of obvious. They are inventing their own science, which is bullshit science. Sorry for that, but that is pure fact, and I think they know it, but they are in total denial. Passing by that Islamic art museum, I passed by the place where Netanyahu have his own residence. I think it's more official, and the private one is one that I asked the security guard there, can I pass by? Yes. And I stabbed him on the shoulder. No, I hugged his shoulder and good Shabbat Shalom, I said, because even on Thursday we say Shabbat Shalom to those that we pass by or do some business with, because we may not see each other before Shabbat. So we wish everybody Shabbat Shalom on our way. Coming outside that area, which is highly protected, with a low status, even me, I can pass by without any objection. I have been denied before, occasionally, but this time I got to enter it. Passing by this square, hostage square in Jerusalem, and I told them that I tried to find the hostage square in Tel Aviv, but I was walking all day, I couldn't find it. Now I found you. Ah, you want to come inside? And yes, of course, I bought a flag and some other items that I'm going to show when I'm in Norway. But for now, I have it preserved, and I pray for the hostages, as I said to the lady that didn't want to have her picture taken. And I totally respect that, agree to that. And she was somewhat impressed that I was showing up from Norway, despite what Norway have said about the Jewish nation here. We are standing together and bring them home now. So this is a contribution of bringing the hostages, bring the Jewish all over the world home. Maybe it seems to be a bit late, but I hope for God's sake they reach Israel in time. Come home, bring my people home, let my people free. So this is a cry out, let the people of Israel be in peace and pray for peace for Jerusalem. And I'm here, yes, to put a smile on everybody. Bye-bye.